Hi. So it's a great honor to speak about the baseline liver ultrasound. And when we talk about this topic, we have to think about what are the agenda. So today I will speak about basic and advanced ultrasound technique, which is available on liver. I will speak about segmental anatomy of the liver. I would like to share some vascular supply of the liver. I would like to clarify the differentiation between portal vein and hepatic vein. Then we give a little short outlook for liver lesion. And finally, I give a short conclusion. So when we start ultrasound, every grayscale examination starts with a conventional grayscale, as we've seen it here. So if you look very carefully on the right side, on the left side, this is an image without any optimization. So every fancy tool like harmonic imaging, speckle reductor imaging is switched off. You see, there is no button on the top of the image, it's just the optimize of the grayscale, but there's no advanced technique available. So you see more speckles there. Sometimes you don't see the vessel completely dark, but this is just the fundamental raw data from the grayscale which we received on the monitor. So there are a couple of techniques available which could optimize your image. One is called tissue harmonic imaging. This will reduce the signal to noise. One is called speckle reductor imaging. So a speckle will be reducted. And the last part will be special compounding. This is also an option. I will explain you later how it's working. So when we start with the first technique, that's tissue harmonic imaging. You see the wave will be sent from the probe in the tissue, and there will be a deformation of this wave. So the wave we received is not the clip complete shape as we send it. So if we look at this deformation, there's a couple of waves included in this wave. So there's a first harmonic imaging, there's a second harmonic imaging, and also third harmonic imaging. So if you summarize the area under the curve, you get this kind of shape. And these frequencies, the probe received these frequencies. There will be a high pass filter, and they will only look for the main frequency for some fundamental frequencies. So they kick off all the kind of signals which have got a bad signal. So now the same information you have seen. So I switched on S-harmonic. You see it there, S-harmonic there. You see the vessels are getting more darker. You see better the border, you get a better penetration. And also on the near field, you get a higher resolution. Speckle reduction imaging is an option that you could minimize the artifact. So if you look very carefully at this pattern here, and ask yourself, did you find any difference in the tint between this part of the area and this part of the area? It will be a challenge, but if you just use an algorithm which bring colors which are same color closer together, you see that this tint a little bit darker in comparison to this tint. And these are exactly the tint from the small spots here. So you see, this technique looks for the structures for different dots, and if the dots I have the same tint, they summarize a couple of dots, and you get a bigger dot in the tint. So you see, it's getting more like an MRI. You see, it's more gray, it's more unique, and also it's more dark because these speckles, which are dark, summarize in this area. The next part will be spatial compounding. So it's the kind of control that the ultrasound beam will be controlled electronically. So you see the wave sent in the tissue from the right side from the probe, and it will send straight from the probe, and then it will be sent also to the left side. And this will be done automatically by the probe and the system. And so it calculates automatically the signal which they received. So if you look very carefully, you have a structure there. You see there's a structure, one beam hit it like this. In the next way, the structure will be hit it straight. And the next beam, the structure will hit from the right side. So we could get more information from the border due to the fact that we have got different scanning angles. You see, now I have just switched on multivision, and also you see that the structure is getting more clearly in comparison to the fundamental grayscale I've shown here at the beginning. But there is also the option that we can use all combination. This is a pure grayscale image without this kind of algorithm. This is the same information where we switch all the stuff on. You see, spectral imaging is on, harmonic is on, and you see immediately that there is an improvement in the quality of the grayscale. You see an improvement of the vascular and also of the pattern of the liver. When we speak about advanced liver ultrasound technique, there's a couple of advanced techniques available. A couple of speakers today will speak about shear wave imaging. So in this talk, I will only speak about image fusion because the rest of the advanced technique will be covered by the other authors. So will it not be great to combine the strengths of CT or MRI on your ultrasound system? So there is an option that you can use these fancy techniques directly on your system. You have to make a decision that you would like to do fusion on CT, MRI, PET-CT or PET-MRI. As long as you have real DICOM data, it's not a problem. You can use all tools. So there is a sensor connected to the probe. Once you have done the registration, the system recognizes what are the movement of this probe during your scanning. And due to the movement of the sensor, the system automatically moves the CT according to your movement. We have done our first scientific research regarding fusion in the year 2005, which was published 2006. At this time, that's nearly 15 years ago, the calibration of the system took us 3 hours. This was only for scientific research, not for diagnostics. Nowadays, you can do this with higher quality in less than 1 minute. So even really big improvement in comparison to the past. You see, there's an overlay technique. You see the lesion either detected on the CT. And here you have got the overlay with color Doppler and grayscale in the area where we have also this lesion seen on the CT. You can also switch on contrast. As we've seen, this lesion was treated. You see contrast arrived. There is less enhancement. Most of this area doesn't show any enhancement. So successful treatment and also in the later phase, no major enhancement, all a little bit in the middle of this lesion. So successful treatment of a liver mass as we've seen it here, which was also confirmed in the CT information. When we speak about liver anatomy, you have to think about what are the main topics in the liver. So we have got three major lobes. One is called the right lobe, as we've seen it here, the left lobe, and we have also a very small lobe at this area, the caudated lobe. When I prepare this talk, I ask myself, how can I share the images and make a clear lecture to understand where are the borders between the right and left lobe? So you see there, this is the middle liver vein. On the left side, you have got the left liver lobe. Everything which is on the right side of this liver lobe, this is the right liver lobe. So the middle liver vein divide the liver in the left liver lobe and right liver lobe. That's an easy one. If you would like to share whether it's really the liver vein, you could use the color Doppler and you see there's the left liver vein, the middle liver vein, and right liver vein. There is a kind of segment from Kuhnau which divides the liver in 9 segments. So you have got segment 1 is a very, very small one. Then you've got 2, 3, 4A, and 4B. This will be the left liver lobe. And there's segment 8, 7, 6, and 5. This will be the right liver lobe. You see also the branches from the liver vein and the portal vein, which is very important to make a clear border or clear decision what segment we are seeing, what segment we are talking about. So we already have seen this is the border between the left envelope and the right envelope. And you see, according to Conneau, that the segment 2, this will be in this area. This will be segment 4A. You've seen it here or here. This will be segment 8. And finally, this area is segment 7. If we now switched our probe in this kind of scanning, you could see we detect segment number 7 and 6. There's a 7 and there's a 6. So this will be the segment 7. And in this area, there will be segment 6. If we now go on to the ABC, and you will see this is segment 8 and 5. So that will be segment 8 and 5. And there's part of the portal branch, which divide the between the segment 8 and 5. As we've seen it here, segment 8 and 5, and also in the middle, that's a portal branch. Now, if we go further on, we see still the IVC. There is a very small segment that's called segment 1. And on the top, we have got the segment 4A. You see this is the liver vein and part of the portal branch here. And in this area, we have got the segment 4B. Finally, we go to the lateral part of the left liver lobe. So you see the segment 2 and segment 3. So it will be here about segment 2 and about segment 3 in this area, as seen also in the animation of Conneau. There are also some structures in the liver which are very important for the ligamentum teres. So this is the ligament as we've seen it here. It's in hypogenic structures. Sometimes if you have got less experience, my students told me there's a lesion. This is a hemangioma. No, I said not a hemangioma. There's here, it's a ligamentum. This is the axial plane. And also if we shift now the probe in the sagittal plane, you see the complete extent of this ligamentum. Sometimes we be careful. That's not a focal liver lesion. That's ligamentum of the liver. Regarding the vessels, we have got a couple of vessels which supply the liver. So we start with the right liver vein. So this is the right liver lobe. This is the right liver vein. Remember, this is the border between the left and right liver lobe. If we switch to the middle liver vein, you see there is the middle liver vein, which divides the liver in the left lobe and right lobe. And finally, we have also the right liver vein, as we've seen it here. There is the left liver vein, as we've seen it here. This was the right liver vein, middle liver vein, left liver vein. So if we look for the Doppler of the hepatic vein, we see that it reflects a kind of respiratory phase, as we've seen it here. So if you have got a deep inspiration or a valsalva, that reduce something, reduce the pulsation artifact, as I've seen, for example, in this image here. Normally in the Karl Doppler, the blood should flow towards the IVC and heart. That's the reason why it's colored in blue. So normally we see that the blood is flowing in this direction, so away from the transducer, and you see the pulsatility of the IVC as we've seen it here. Hepatic artery have got a little different pattern. We see the hepatic artery is just adjacent to the portal vein, and the flow direction is the same as the portal vein. So if you would like to exclude portal hypertension, make sure that the flow direction between the hepatic artery and the portal vein is same. Sometimes if you have got portal hypertension, there will be an inverse flow of the portal vein called in blue. So when we look at the main portal vein, as we've seen it here, this is a huge portal vein, which divide in the right and left branch. The portal vein is responsible for around about 70 to 80% of the blood supply of the liver. The hepatic artery just care about 20 to 30%. So if there is an increased flow of the portal vein, there will be a compensation of the hepatic artery. So if you would like to look at the pulse wave Doppler, you see the pattern from the portal vein has completely different shape in comparison to the hepatic artery and the liver vein. So it's a hepatopetal flow. This means there is no inverse flow and the velocity is very low, between 15 centimeters to 30 centimeters in a second. There is a slight undulation of the pattern in the car Doppler, or in the pulse wave Doppler. So this also reflects some cardiac variation as we've seen it here. So the main portal branch is seen here. You also see that's a conjunction between the main portal branch and the right and left. And if you look clearly, you see this is the main portal branch. This portal branch goes here to the right liver lobe. And this other is the left part of the left portal vein, as seen it here. There is this. Then it's the main part. And this is just from the pancreas. Same information in color Doppler. You see left portal branch, right portal branch, main portal branch, adjacent, there's a hepatic artery. Where is the difference between the portal vein and hepatic vein? So it's very important if you tell the student very easy that there is a major difference. So hepatic vein go between lobes and segments. So the blood supply is intersegmental and interlobar, as we've seen it here. The portal vein are intrasegmental here, so they cross directly the segmental, as we've seen it here. That's a major difference. Also, if you look at the wall structures, the portal vein has got these bright echogenic wall structures, which are completely missing on the liver vein. And also, if you see at the or compare the flow pattern, you see the flow pattern is completely different in comparison to the flow pattern of the liver vein. There's a couple of lesions available, so this will be focusing later, but are benign lesion and malignant lesion available on the liver. And there could be shown hypogenic, but also hypogenic. So sometimes it could be really a challenge to make a proper decision whether we see an adenoma or an FNH or liver mets. So also you see there's an overlap because sometimes FNH could hypogenic, but there also could be hypoechogenic. The same also shown on liver mets. So when we look at these four lesions, they look very similar. So when we only have the grayscale, probably you could flip a coin to make a decision, where is the liver mets? Now you have your time, look carefully and tell me where is the liver mets. Most of my colleagues tell me this will be the liver mets. I said, no, this is the hemangioma. Okay, what about this lesion? It's not so hypogenic as we've seen it here. This is an FNH. And here, that's an adenoma. And this, that's a mets from a neuroendocrine tumor. So this is a liver mets. But only if you only compare this in grayscale, it's a good chance to make the wrong diagnosis because it looks very, very similar. So ultrasound is an excellent method for detecting liver lesion. For small cysts, we could even make a proper diagnosis with a diameter less than 0.5 centimeters. We have to think about to distinguish between benign and malignant liver lesion. Therefore, contrast is very helpful. And you can use also this tool, ultrasound, for diagnosis, either for follow-up after intervention, or you could guided interventions directly by ultrasound. So in conclusion, today I have shown you the latest ultrasound technique which is available. I have spoken about liver anatomy. I have shown you the typical pattern of hepatic vessels. We have spoken a little bit about focal liver mass, which will be go more in extension by my last talk when we speak about contrast. I would like to thank you for your attention. I'm open for questions.